Good morning and welcome back to my channel. I feel like I'm on the early shift again because we dashed into group, did the weigh-in, and we have places to go. I'll tell you about that in a minute. Right, the reason I'm standing here with my coat on this morning is because I was texting a couple of Slimming World friends during the week and I said that I'd been to Jewels and bought a new winter coat. So I wanted to do, I'll do an outfit of the day. This is my new coat from Jewels. I wonder if I can show it you, but it's interesting really because this is the first full length, I mean this is down to just above my knee, this is the first full length winter coat I've had in many, many years. I'm usually a jacket person. And I was thinking the last time I bought an actual full length winter coat must have been 20 years ago. But I can remember it like it was yesterday because I was in Evans. It was navy blue, like this one is. It was a size 26. And on the day I bought it, it didn't fasten. It was too small. And I remember saying to my husband at the time, it's all right, I'm on a diet. It'll fit me before the weather gets really bad. Well, I'm going to stand here and tell you today, it never did fit me. It never did fasten. And I never did like wearing it. And one of the excuses I used to make during the winter was, I'm a hot person, which I am always, I'm quite a warm-blooded person. I'm a hot person, I don't need to fasten my coat. I only need to wear a t-shirt underneath it. And I'm telling you now, in all honesty, that was always because my coats never fitted me properly because I wasn't prepared to go up to the next size. I should have bought a 28 on that occasion. So my coats never fitted me properly and I could never get more than a t-shirt underneath them. And today what I like about clothing is when I need to, I can layer it up. Right, saw this coat in John Lewis, I think it might have been last Sunday, it was last weekend anyway, but they only had it in a size 16. And so I rang the local Jewels shop and said, do you have it in a smaller size? Yeah, we've got it in every size. So I said, great, will you put me a size 12 aside and I'll come in and try it on during the week. And they did, they put me a size 12 and Joe and I went in on Wednesday to get it and the 12 buried me, it was miles too big. Never bought clothing in Jewels before, but I will be going back. Some of their stuff is a bit flowery for me, but I did like their coats and things. So I've actually got a size 10 winter coat, and it fits me. And I've got plenty of room in it. And I'm just chuffed because to go from a size 26 that didn't fit many years ago to a size 10 that does fit, it's just a lovely feeling. And I'm just so grateful. Anyway, show you my coat. It has a double zip. You can unzip it from the bottom if you want to sit down in your car or whatever. But I don't need to because I've got loads of room in it anyway. I like it because the bottom half is sort of quilted lined. But the top portion is fleecy furry. The sleeves are silky lined. So you don't struggle to get your arms into the sleeves, which is something. When I've had jackets before that have been fleecy all over, they tend to cling to your trousers at the bottom or they cling to your jumpers in the sleeves. So that's something I'd look for today. So yeah, Jewels, and I really like it. It's not heavy because it's waterproof. That was another thing. When we're looking for a winter coat, and we tend to get a lot of wet weather in the winter in this country, 9 out of 10 winter coats that I've tried on this winter have not even been shower resistant, but they've been this kind of parka type finish. So this is nice and light and totally waterproof, which is what I need because we walk a lot. We tend to be out on foot a lot. Right, rest of the outfit. Whistles top, which you've seen before, and Wallis trousers. So that's me today. I'll tell you why we came back from group early, and it's because one of my very dear friends was 85 yesterday. And what we do when it's birthdays, we buy a birthday gift, but we also do a treat where if it's your birthday, you choose where you want to go for your meal and the other person pays. So as it was my friend's birthday yesterday, she chooses where we eat and I pay, and she's chosen Chinese. And so a couple of villages away from where we live, and there is a really nice Chinese restaurant. And this is another part of what I'm going to be talking about today. So that's why I'm back from group early, because she's picking me up at 12 o'clock. And also Joe's got places to be. I'm not going to say it was a good group, because I obviously didn't stay. It was Miss Slinky and Mr. Sleek. I asked not to be included in nominations because I've been there so long, it's not fair when you keep getting, I mean, I'm saying that's not what I feel about other people. It's not fair for me to keep getting put forward as somebody who's lost 13 stone, although I've only lost just short of 5 stone of that, that's Living World. I feel awkward about it because there are a lot of people in my group who've lost 3, 4, 5 stone and they should be up there talking about their success. And every time it comes around, you've always got a new influx of members, and so they're always like, oh wow, 13 stone, and they nominate you, and again you go round and round, and it just doesn't seem, well, I don't want it anymore. That's why. And also the taster groups, I'm not that bothered about staying to taster groups these days because most of the food I wouldn't eat. It's a lot of artificial sweeteners and stuff like that that I don't eat. And I've said it before, I don't eat that kind of food at 9, 10 o'clock in the morning. It's just not me anymore. I'm so happy to be eating the way I'm eating that I just don't want to be eating Slimming World puddings and things at 10 o'clock in the morning. I'm not criticising what anybody else does, that's their choice. So yeah, I went into group, I'll give you my results before I go on. Went into group, got weighed, as we do, stand in the queue, do your thing and all that. Got on the scales and my little lad jinxed me again. We laugh about this because Joe says when he stays for weighing I always gain. I don't think it's anything to do with it really, but I'll let him take responsibility. I gained a pound this week and I'm perfectly happy with that because I haven't done anything any different to what I generally do. I haven't eaten in any different fashion. I haven't eaten anything I shouldn't, and I haven't been off plan. I've had 99 of 105 since, which is very similar to last week when I had 100. I've had a good week. I've eaten well, and I'm very happy with the result. I've just compared it to where I was at the beginning of last month, because I like to look at what I've done over the month. And I am actually half a pound lighter than I was at the start of October. So at the beginning of October, I was 9 stone 1, and today I'm 9 stone and half a pound. I really can't grumble at that, because I'm sure in the long run, this is what maintaining is. And this is why Slimming World give us that 6 pound leeway, because we are going to roll around within that 6 pounds. I can't be bothered to stress myself about losing weight. I'm literally trying my hardest to like eat and enjoy it and know I'm eating the right things and feel comfortable about it and hopefully stay within those 6 pounds. And at the moment that seems to be working, so I'm going to continue to roll with it. I want to talk about a couple of food things, and I want to tell you about some thinking in my week. Let me get it right. Some thinking in my week. Food item. Can I show you an Aldi Rogan Josh? Is it from their extra special range, Joe?
Specially selected.
Specially selected range. This is lovely. If you like a hotter Rogan Josh. I mean, I think Rogan Josh varies at different restaurants, different takeaways. It can be medium, it can be quite hot. I don't know, does that have chilies on it to signify? I would describe this as a hot.
Yeah, it's 2 out of 3.
Now, if that's 2 out of 3, I wouldn't want to have a 3. This is what I would call a good hot Rogan Josh. It makes your nose run, it makes your eyes run, and if you had a cold, it would be a really good cure. It's nice, but it's hot. So if you're a person who likes a mild Rogan Josh, I think you'd find this a bit on the hot side. It's £2.49 in Aldi, and it's 1.5 sins. It's good. Every time I have it, I say to Joe, I'm not going to have another one, it's too hot for me. And then I can't resist it, I'll have another one. So I've got one for my lunch tomorrow. That's that. I said I'd report back on the Iceland sushi, the frozen sushi. It actually is, in my opinion, quite nice. I would give it an 8 out of 10. It's not the best sushi because it has been frozen. It alters the texture of the rice a bit. But if I'm stuck and I can't get any sushi, I've now got plenty in the freezer to fall back on. I was a bit put out this week when we went to Sainsbury's, our local Sainsbury's, and they haven't even got a space anymore for the vegetable sushi. It's gone. They've got the fish one, which is nice, but the vegetable one they're not stocking anymore. And it's quite a drive to our big Sainsbury's. So unless I'm in town and I can pick it up in one of the Sainsbury's branches in the city, it looks like my very favourite sushi is off the menu for a while. But never mind, that's life. You can't worry about things like that when it comes to food. I can't worry about things like that when it comes to food. I'm not going to let food ruin my life anymore. If I can't get vegetable sushi that I really, really love, I'll have the second best, the fish one. If I can't get the fish one, I'll eat the Iceland one. If I can't get that, I'll eat something else. The world is full of delicious food, and so much of it is accessible to people on Slimming World. Because one thing I'm learning on this planet is, if, for me, finally getting the focus of eating junk, eating cakes and breads and pastries and sweets and chocolates and puddings and all that, the things I used to eat all the time, the things I used to obsess about eating all the time, now I've let go of a lot of that stuff. And of course you can have that in moderation on plan if you want it, and I do, in moderation on plan, but I don't focus on all of that first, and I'm learning to focus on eating real food, real fruit, real vegetables, real meat, real fish. I think I've had meat once this week, I've had fish all the rest of the week, because I'm enjoying it. I'm not on a diet.
You had the Slimming World chickpea thing and thought that was really good.
Oh yeah, the side dish, there's the aloo gobi, and then there was another one, which I can't remember what it was called, but it was chickpeas and vegetables. And that actually was really nice. And although it's a side dish, I found it with vegetables and I had bulgur wheat with it. I had vegetables with it and I had buckwheat with it, and it is enough for a main course. It's not tiny, it's plenty, isn't it, Joe?
Mm.
He knows because he cooked it. But yeah, I had that. But apart from that, I've eaten fish all week and I absolutely love salmon. Fresh salmon, poached salmon, whatever. But you know, if you just said to me when I went to Slimming World, your first Slimming World meal, or your first meal on the Slimming World plan, Jane, is going to be salmon, I'd have, no, I'd probably thrown up. I never ate salmon back then. I thought I didn't like it. In fact, I didn't eat fish really, only occasionally from the chippy, and then it would have been a fish cake.
Yeah, you only started eating fish maybe like a month or two ago.
Yeah, probably in the
with
last
the poached salmon. Yeah. You had it every once in a blue moon.
Yeah, but then eating more salmon has been the last 2 or 3 months, definitely. And yeah, that it amazes me because, you know, we talk about this plan and we say it's not a diet. If we're absolutely honest, it is a diet, isn't it? Come on, we all know that. But it's a different kind of diet for me, because dieting for me always used to be like Operation Starvation, eating lettuce, eating cottage cheese, which is something I don't dislike, but something I very rarely eat. But if I put it bluntly, making myself eat things I didn't really enjoy because they were diet foods. So vegetables that I didn't like, and just food that was diet food, or people had always perceived it to be diet food. And I always lived like I was on a diet. I never got slim, but I lived like I was on a diet. You know, the only time, I'll be honest with you, the only time I buy things like Ryvitas and cottage cheese and that kind of stuff is if I'm on a diet. And I can't do it today because it reminds me of being on a diet. So, like, I'm on a food plan now that we call Slimming World and everything. For the first time in my life, I feel like I eat like a normal person because I'm not paranoid about food. And I make better choices naturally, which brings me on to speaking about, let me just do these two other food items and then I'll go to speaking about what I want to speak about. Oh, I've done one because I've reported back on sushi. The other food thing was, has anybody else noticed that Aldi have changed their 5% minced beef? Not only is it in different packaging, because we buy the 250-gram one, but not only has it gone into different packaging, it's actually, it's not such a fine mince anymore, it's more roughly minced. And two nights running you had gristle in it, didn't you?
Yeah.
So we're not buying it now. We've gone on to Morrison's, which is a finer mince and doesn't have gristle in it. We were surprised by the older one because we've been buying it for years. But in the last fortnight, it's really changed. And I just wondered if anybody else had experienced that, or whether it's a local phenomenon. Can't say that. Skip that. Whether it's a local occurrence. Right, okay. So yeah, that was that. But what I wanted to talk about in my thinking this week, right, a couple of things happened to me. Firstly, when we talked about it being my friend's birthday, and I said to her, where do you want to eat? And she said, oh, can I go to, I'm not going to name the restaurant, well, I won't, it's called The Shard. It's a Chinese restaurant in, I said, a couple of villages away from where I live. I want to go to The Shard, please. So I said, oh, fine, okay. So she said, will you book it? And I said, yeah, you drive, I'll book it. So I rang up to book the restaurant, and I spoke to this really lovely young Chinese guy. And I said, I wanted to book for Saturday, blah, 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 blah. And he's like, oh, yes. He said, that's our buffet session. And I thought, excuse my French, oh, shit. I don't do buffets of any kind. Because for me, a buffet is, you know, we talk about having trigger foods. Well, for me, a buffet is a trigger meal because I don't know when to stop. Although today I know what it feels like to be full, and I'm not full, satisfied, buffet food just switches everything off in my head and I go into silly mode. And I can't stop going back for more. Does anybody else feel like this? Does anybody else experience this? Oh my God. When he said it, that's our buffet session. And I thought, I don't want to do that. I don't have to do that. So I just took a calming breath and I said to him very politely, do you have an a la carte menu for the evening? And he said, yes. And he said, but it's a lot more. I'm trying not to do a Chinese accent here. It's a lot more expensive, he said. I thought, I don't care. So I said, could we have the a la carte menu at lunchtime? Is that possible? And he said, oh, yes. He said, but the buffet is only £20. And I was like, yeah, that's fine, I know that, but can I have the a la carte menu, please? And he said, yeah, no problem. I came off the phone, I breathed a sigh of relief because I had gone totally into panic mode. I honestly can't deal with buffets. I just can't. And I don't want to put myself in that place. I just don't have to do that anymore. So we're going for lunch today and they're going to give us the a la carte menu. And we can choose whatever we like and then cook it fresh for us. And that works for me. Because I know where going for a buffet meal would have taken me. And it would have taken me way, way over what I should be eating. And it would have taken me off plan in a way that I would have found hard to get back onto plan. Because it's the style of eating. And with me, I've said this before, and I don't know if everybody really gets what I mean by it, but I do. It's not what I eat 9 times out of 10. It's how I eat it. So if I could have gone up to that buffet and just thought, I'm going to get one plateful of food, come back to the table, sit down and eat it and enjoy it, I'd have been fine. But that's not what buffet thinking does to me. A buffet to me is like, get as much as you can. Okay, it's 20 quid.
Challenge, isn't it?
It's a challenge.
Yeah. And you want your money's worth.
It's 20 quid. I want my money's worth. In fact, I'm such an arsehole. You're going to charge me 20 quid. I'm going to eat £40 worth. And it's like, brings up this like feeling in me. So go up there, get a plateful. I'm not focused on eating that plateful of food. In my head, I'm thinking, how soon can I get back up to that table and get another plateful? It's insanity. Absolute insanity. So it's not what I eat, it's the way I eat it. And buffet is never going to be in a healthy fashion by me.
Russet apples were the same thing.
Russet apples were the same because some clever guy behind the camera decided to buy me some russet apples because they look so good.
Yeah.
What happened? I had one on the first day. I was fine. I had 3 on the second day. That was not fine. Not because apples are going to make me fat, but because it's the insanity of how I eat it. So they've all gone now anyway. And the second thing that happened this week, I have a really good friend who has an 11-year-old daughter. Near where we live, there's a really big garden centre and it goes overboard at Christmas. It's amazing. It's really nice. So we have this little tradition that come the beginning of November, we go on what we call our Christmas mooch, and we buy some Christmas things, and we buy some presents, and we buy decorations and Christmas things. They bought you a robin, didn't they?
Yes.
It's really nice. But we do that, and we go and we have a big hot chocolate with the works. Well, we used to. I don't do that anymore. I don't want that anymore. And do you know what's really daft? I've done that for years, gone and had this big hot chocolate, and you get a couple of flakes with it, and it's loaded with cream, and it's got all these marshmallow, little marshmallows on top and everything. I don't like marshmallow. I really don't like marshmallow. I don't like the texture of it. So I'd go there every week, but I was not going to lose out. If you're paying £5 for a hot chocolate, I'm going to have the marshmallows I paid for. Again, it's the insanity, isn't it? I don't like marshmallows. Why did I used to do it? And it is a big hot chocolate, but it's no bigger than my coconut latte. And it's a load. I like flakes, but they were never Cadbury's flakes, so they can keep those. They're rubbish. And, you know, you go through that process and you do it because it's tradition, or you do it, in my case, because you're greedy. But you don't do it because you're going to enjoy it. So anyway, we went there, we had our Christmas mooch, and then we went into the food area and we queued up with all these dozens and dozens and dozens of other people who'd had, excuse me, I'm hungry. All these dozens and dozens of other people who had had the same idea as us, you know, it's first day of it, let's get on with it, 1st of November. And we queued and we queued and we queued, and we got to the front of the queue, and my friend's daughter had said to me, "Are you going to have the hot chocolate?" They, you know, they got sandwiches and cake as well, which I didn't want because I got a cooked lunch when I got home. "Are you going to have the hot chocolate?" And she calls me Sparkle. "Are you going to have the hot chocolate, Sparkle?" And I went, "No, I'm going to have coffee." And she's like, "Oh, okay," because she's used to me now. So we get to the front of the queue, and the girl says, "What do you want to drink?" And my friend's daughter said, "Two of the big hot chocolates." And then she looked at me, the lady looked at me, and she went, "And you?" And my brain was trying to say, with the best will in the world, a mocha coffee. And then something like clicked back into gear, and I thought, what are you doing? Mocha coffee's got chocolate in it. You don't do chocolate anymore. You don't want chocolate anymore. But it just shows that old thinking. It will still try and sneak out to catch you.
Stinking thinking.
Stinking thinking. Exactly. That's what Alcoholics Anonymous call it. Stinking thinking. So my brain is going mocha, mocha, mocha. And my mouth opened and went flat white. Thank God. And I had a flat white coffee. But when I looked it up afterwards, that was six sins for flat white. You know? I don't want to exceed my 15 sins a day unless it's a day like today and I'm specifically going out for lunch and I'm going to have a nice time. But I'm not going to eat chocolate. I am going to have a starter. I am going to have a main course. I'll probably have a dessert and coffee, or one or the other or both. But I'm not going to eat chocolate because I don't eat chocolate anymore and I don't want to trigger myself off and I don't want to feel crap.
You don't want to eat them blooming sardines.
Oh yeah, I'd have to eat that to the sardines.
Make you eat them sardines.
Yeah. But I don't want to feel crap. I want to feel as good as I feel and as slim as I feel and as healthy as I feel and as not bloated as I feel and as excited as I feel for life. Because chocolate's a nice thing, but it's not everything. And it used to be my drug of choice. And thank God, today I'm clean. I don't need it. And, you know, we've just been through a week of, well, no, we've just been through a month of bloody chocolate obsession with Halloween. When somebody can explain to me what on earth Halloween has got to do with chocolate. Okay, kids like sweets, they do trick or treat. Don't mean the mother has to eat it all, does it? So I'm the mother. I don't need to eat it all. And now we're all obsessing because it's like, oh, look at the chocolates in the shops for Christmas. What's Christmas got to do with chocolate? I say it every year. I really believe it. What the hell? And there are times in my life when I really, really resent being blind. They don't happen very often these days. But there are some times when it stops me doing things. But there are times in my life today when I'm quite grateful because I don't have to be faced by all this junk when I go to the supermarket. I know what it looks like. I know what it tastes like. And I'm happy to be rid of it.
Sorry, you've got 25 minutes.
Okay, got to go. It's been a really good week, a pound on, but that's okay. I'm a Target member and I'm in Target and I couldn't ask for more than that. And I'll be back next week. And it may be a bit more on next week, depending on today's meal and but it will only be one meal off that, because that's all I need to do. And I want to stay in the shape I'm in. So, see you next week. Have a good one. Take care.
Bye. Remember.
Remember, it does work if you work it. It more than likely won't if you don't.
It won't work if you don't.
It won't work
if you don't. Okay. Right, see you later.
Bye.